So I need to stand for my speakers and also my scrapwood pile is growing, so I will build one. The heart of the stand will be this beam here. It has a quite beautiful life edge side, I will keep that. And then I will add on the bottom and on the top part I will add basically wood pieces so that it's stable and you can put a speaker on it. So the height for your speaker stand comes from the height of your tweeter, I think it's called, the part of the box which making the high frequencies. And that should be on the height of your ears. So depending if you want to listen to music in sitting or standing, so probably for me it's sitting. So you're measuring the height of your ear, then you know the height of your tweeter, then you're measuring the rest of the box and you know basically the height of your speaker. So for me it's like about 70 centimeters the speaker height minus the width, height of these blades with coming on the top and the bottom, and then you get your length for your middle piece. So I cut the pieces roughly to size and this is what it would look like, but I think, I don't know, it's not really proportional. The top is fine, but the bottom for me is looks too big. So in addition that I reduced the width of the base, it was only 1 centimeter in width, but what in depth I removed 5 centimeters. And I think the effect is visible, and actually now I'm happy. I think it's more balanced this way. So now I have to do some sanding because one here there's paint on it. And also this back side here is rough sawn, so I also need to sand that down. I had to stop and show you this. I really like the look of it. You can see that depending on the grains, because of different heights, there's more paint. And it's really looking nice. It's not what I'm looking for in this project, but maybe for a future project I will do something like this, paint it. And then remove the paint partially so that you get basic crane pattern where the paint is left. So I sanded the back side of the exposed piece only slightly, basically that the glue is attaching better to the surface, but you won't see it, so I didn't bother with removing all of the paint. I burned the wood until basically the charcoal peeled off, but in some spaces you can still see bright spots I don't like this hard contrast, so I will use a stain that will stain basically the bright spots into a brown, and then we will oil it. The first coat of linseed oil is quite important because the oil mixes with the charcoal and the stain and thus getting it in every crack. So you will notice that if you touch the wood when the oil is not oxidized, you will get black fingers. But when the oil is fully oxidized, it has fixed the charcoal and stain to the wood, so there's no color on my finger here. Now would be the time for the second and third time with linseed oil, but somehow something went wrong. I don't know actually what happened. Somehow got out of square. The problem is that I already, of course, plugged in the holes on the top, so I only have access to the bottom. So what I have to do is loosen the screws here, break the glue joint here, then I will apply new glue, attach one screw, line it up and put the other screw in, then we should be fine and ready for the final finish. The problem is a little bit at the moment that if I put it like this, it will basically auto-align these two good pieces, but here's still the hole in it, so if I drive in the screw, it wants to go in the same position like it was before, so it will tilt the whole thing again. So I think I will use a clamp and try to keep it aligned when I drive the screw in. Thank you.
Thank you.